amazing would it be if humans could halt the aging process? Just imagine, someone informs you that Betelgeuse is set to go supernova in approximately 200 years, and you wouldn't want to miss that for anything. Unfortunately, you would never live to witness it. But consider this, what if you had the option to freeze yourself, temporarily pausing all biological functions, and be revived just days before the grand Betelgeuse event? It would undoubtedly be a crazy experience, don't you agree? While we're still far from discovering the elusive elixir of eternal life or perfecting cryogenic hibernation to awake centuries in the future, nature has already outpaced us. Recently, scientists have successfully revived and resuscitated a preserved organism from 46,000 years ago. And the key to its exceptional preservation lies in ice. Nematodes. I want you to go out, find a piece of soil, and grab a handful of it. Congratulations, now you're holding thousands of microscopic worms in your hand. Those worms are called nematodes, and they are the most abundant, multicellular animals on Earth. Many of them are parasites of insects, plants, or animals, while others are free-living species that feed on bacteria, fungi, and even other nematodes. Interestingly, despite their vast numbers, the majority of nematode species are still not well understood biologically. Nematodes showcase extraordinary resilience, making them one of the most robust organisms discovered on Earth. This was demonstrated during an experiment conducted on the 2003 Space Shuttle Columbia mission, where nematode worms were subjected to the re-entry breakup to assess their survival capabilities. Remarkably, they became the first known life form to endure an unprotected atmospheric descent and survive upon reaching Earth's surface. They are structurally simple creatures. An adult nematode is made up of around 1,000 somatic cells, with potentially hundreds of cells associated with their reproductive system. They can be described as a tube within a tube, referring to their alimentary canal that stretches from their mouth at the front end to their anus near the tail. While they possess digestive, nervous, excretory, and reproductive systems, they lack a distinctive circulatory or respiratory system. In terms of size, nematodes can range from a tiny 0.3 millimeters to over 8 meters in length. Most nematodes reside in the soil throughout their life cycle, regardless of whether they feed above or below ground. While their movement is limited on land, they possess the ability to swim in water and navigate through moist soil at a faster pace. Thus, maintaining well-drained soil is advisable. Moreover, nematodes can spread through various means, such as tools, boots, animals, and infected plants, which can carry particles of infested soil. Although the oldest ones recorded date back approximately 400 million years, scientific hypotheses suggest that they might have existed even a billion years ago. Thriving in moist and humid conditions, as well as warm soil, these organisms have recently been found capable of preservation in ice for thousands of years. An example of this was a nematode discovered in the Siberian permafrost, which remained in a dormant state for the past 46,000 years until scientists successfully revived it. The study. How was this possible? Allow me to explain. Some animals, including tardigrades, rotifers, and nematodes, have the ability to survive harsh conditions by entering a dormant state called cryptobiosis. For the sake of this brand new study, some scientists took samples from a fossilized burrow in silt deposits in the northeastern Arctic. Analysis of plant material from the burrow using radiocarbon analysis revealed that these frozen deposits, located 40 meters below the surface, had remained frozen since the late Pleistocene, approximately 45,839 to 47,769 years ago, and they contained a bunch of nematodes. Now let's imagine you are one of these tiny worms, and scientists want to learn more about you. They use some fancy tools and methods like reading its special instruction book, putting together the pieces of information, and figuring out how this worm is related to other worms. In scientific terms, they perform genome sequencing, assembly, and phylogenetic analysis. Surprise! They discover that you are a part of a brand new group that no one knew about before. They gave you a cool name, Panagrulimius colimaensis. That's pretty much what happened to our 46,000-year-old nematode. To understand more about how these worms survive through tough situations, the scientists compared the instruction books of our new worm friend and another worm called Cnorhabditis elegans, which is like a supermodel worm that scientists often study. When they made both worms a little bit dry in the lab, the worms started making more of a special sugar called trihalose. This sugar seems to help them stay alive when things get really dry or super cold. The team experimented to check how good our new worm friend was at surviving. They found that if they made the worm a little dry before freezing it, it could go into special survival mode, cryptobiosis, and survive being super cold at minus 80 degrees Celsius. This study has showcased the longest recorded period of cryptobiosis in nematodes, spanning tens of thousands of years. By adapting to ensure extreme conditions such as permafrost for short periods, the nematodes may have acquired the ability to remain dormant for geological timescales. The revival. One crucial point to emphasize is that this particular nematode species has long been extinct. This species completely vanished from Earth's surface since ancient times. Everyone and everything has forgotten about this tiny creature. However, we humans have managed to resurrect it from the dead, bringing it back to life once again. Interestingly, female nematodes can reproduce without the need for a male partner. Consequently, scientists were able to simulate the reproduction of this adorable worm, resulting in hundreds of nematodes now thriving in their laboratories. Unfortunately, the original mother nematode, which had been frozen for 46,000 years, passed away a few days after scientists revived it from the permafrost. They took excellent care of it, providing all the necessary nutrients for its sustenance and survival. Regrettably, the life cycle of these organisms is only a few days long. After 12 days since its revival, the worm died, leaving its offspring to carry on the species. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Astronauts and cryosleep. So at this point, we might ask ourselves if there is any use in this discovery and if we can learn anything from this. This groundbreaking discovery has far-reaching implications for humans, especially in the realm of long space missions, and yes, even the concept of cryosleep. Picture this, astronauts embarking on a journey to distant planets, where travel times are measured in years. Cryosleep, a concept popularized in science fiction, might become a reality. Thanks to the nematode's resilience, we can unlock the secrets of preserving life during long-haul space missions. The nematode's natural adaptation to freezing offers clues on how we might induce a state of suspended animation in humans. If we can harness this ability, astronauts could potentially sleep through the vast, empty stretches of space, conserving resources and minimizing the psychological toll of extended isolation. Just imagine a spaceship equipped with cryosleep pods, where explorers peacefully slumber through the cosmic void, preserving energy and resources for the final frontier. Indeed, cryosleep would allow astronauts to enter an almost null energy required state, significantly reducing the consumption of vital resources such as food, water, and oxygen. Imagine how lighter would a spacecraft be if we could spare most of the astronauts' supplies, because they would be cryosleeping. Also, the psychological challenges would be minimized. The vastness of space and the prolonged isolation can take a toll on astronauts' mental well-being. Astronauts can wake up rejuvenated, ready to face the wonders of the cosmos. On a physical level, long space journeys expose astronauts to the rigors of microgravity and the physical toll of extended spaceflight. Cryosleep, by slowing down bodily functions, offers a unique advantage. Astronauts emerge from their suspended state with reduced physical stress, enhancing their overall endurance. The parallels between the nematode survival and the cryosleep concept in movies like Interstellar are uncanny. It opens up the possibility of humans enduring the harsh realities of deep space travel in a manner akin to our favorite spacefaring characters. While Interstellar is fiction, our discovery of the nematode adds a touch of reality to the dream of prolonged space missions. Dangerous pathogens. According to a recent study, there is growing concern among scientists about the potential reemergence of dangerous pathogens. similar to a nematode that was brought back to life after being frozen for thousands of years. These pathogens could pose a significant threat as they may have been frozen for centuries, resulting in modern humans lacking immunity to them. These worries are amplified by human-induced climate change, which is causing the Earth to warm and leading to the melting of glaciers and permafrost, where these pathogens are believed to be present. By utilizing simulation software developed at Michigan State University, researchers in the study found that ancient pathogens released into the modern world have a high survival rate and tend to evolve, with some becoming dominant species in their new environment and others managing to establish a foothold in the ecosystem. This indicates that climate change-induced melting of permafrost globally could release dominant pathogens that cause extensive damage to ecosystems. Moreover, the researchers estimate that a mere 1% release of dormant pathogens worldwide could trigger this catastrophic outcome. What future lies ahead? As you can understand by studying the remarkable nematode, a minuscule organism that has defied the limitations of time, we may discover a means to explore the vast expanse of the universe. Much like this microscopic wonder has managed to suspend its life for countless millennia, maybe we can do the same. In the near future, our knowledge of cryosleep and suspended animation could potentially enable us to navigate through space while preserving the vital essence of life. Moreover, this advanced understanding might even allow us to witness extraordinary events that would otherwise elude us, such as the eventual majestic explosion of Betelgeuse. That's all for this video. As we conclude our celestial journey, feel free to share your thoughts on this video in the comments below. Are you scared of the potential reemergence of dangerous pathogens? We'll see you soon on the channel.